Is your laptop slow? Are you a victim of the death wheel? Are you finally ready to speed up your laptop? Well, in this video, we'll show you how to upgrade the RAM and storage of the 2011 MacBook Pro. Actually, the late 2011.
Hello and welcome to this video. If you subscribe, welcome back. If you're new, we're in this channel, we mainly focus on tech. Thank you so much for your support in this channel. It means a lot to us. Don't forget to subscribe and smash that like for us. Let's get to the video. Just quickly before we start, comment below your favorite features and the least favorites of the MacBook Pro. Let's start. So to start this video, we need the MacBook Pro. I have the late 2011 version. And it's pretty beat up actually, there's damages everywhere, of course, but I have the SSD, external SSD attached to the outside of it, but I'll put it inside and I'll do a video in the future on that. I'll put it inside instead of the disk. Today we're gonna upgrade the storage from a hard disk into a solid state drive SSD, and bought the Samsung 860 Evo. I read some reviews and it's pretty good, so we'll see how it performs with the old computer. And then also you need some tools. I've just got some tools here, just iPhone opening tools, you know. To start opening the laptop, you need a Philips 00, and once we go inside, we're gonna need another as well as we go on, and I'll explain through. All right, so to start, so make sure you open, you start from one side and then top three, there's a long screws. So make sure you remember that. So just letting you guys know that this one and this one and this one, all these three screws are longer and the rest is just smaller. And then once you're done, you flip.
So I'm done taking off the screws. Now you just flip it up and then put it on the side, and then this is the hard drive that I want to replace today. And this was the RAM that I upgraded to 16 gigs from, I think it was 8 or 4. I'm not sure, but yeah, this looks like it needs a bit of a cleaning, eh? Holy hell. Damn, that fan though, needs a bit of cleaning. Yeah, I might do that later. This is next, so
we're gonna take it out and replace it with this one. The installation is very simple. So all you do is you take these two screws out on the top, and then you just, one side, you lift it up. Make sure you don't put any screws, or make sure you don't put any, nothing sharp underneath, because there's a cable that runs here. So make sure you be aware of that.
Next step is to open these two screws and then you lift it off. The issue because it's stuck here because of this damage here. So that section's annoying a little bit. Let's see where I go. Okay, got it. That wasn't that hard. So you would want to take this out. So there it is. I took it out. There's dust everywhere. But you can keep this, and everything that you have inside, you can always go back to it. So there's my backtab iPhone, you know, for many years. I'll go back to it. You can just follow the process again and replace it with this one, restart the computer. Should work. Alright, so this step now, open this SSD and install it in. 860 Evo 1 terabyte, and it just goes in there. Let's see if it does me any good. So this bracket thing has two sides. See this side? It's like flattish. This side's a bit pointy, so make sure the pointy is to the end or the beginning of, towards the connection. Okay, so then now that's in place and there's no gaps. And before you put the cover on, you can wipe your computer, whatever you need to do. But don't do it because you might damage something. So what you'll do now is turn it over, put the cover on just in case, and then turn the computer on so it turns on. And then you would want to put the rest of the screws on. And as simple as that. This will be your welcoming screen, but make sure you turn it off again and then turn it on while holding the option key, and then this will happen. So you could make a backup and, you know, recover from a USB at this stage. If you have it, you put a USB in here, a USB connected up, and it will show up there, so you can do that. but I'm gonna go do it through the other way. So I'm gonna log into my Wi-Fi and follow it that way. And then it asks you to do internet recovery. It says internet recovering, it may take a while. So after it does, but I think it took 3 minutes, and then you come into this. So you can restore from backup machine, install OSX or GitHub online or this utilities. So I'm gonna go. So before you, I wanna install a fresh version of macOS. So before you do that, make sure you go Dix utility, and then you go inside here and make sure you go into the 1 terabyte that I just installed, and I have to erase it, or yeah, I'll erase it and make it into macOS. So I'll just call it Mac 1 terabyte SSD. So this drive has become available, you know. And this should do the job. And then I can install the new version of OS X by going out of here and going through the process. This should work. And then it should ask you to select your disk, and you would select then Mac 1TB, which we just created, and that's 1 terabyte, that's the SSD, and then we'll install it, and then I'll see you guys after this one. This should take a little bit. So we're gonna boot up this MacBook Pro and see how long it takes. So 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! How long is it gonna take? Wow, that was quick.
Okay, so I just finished off with the upgrade and I turned the computer on and everything. It's pretty good and the boot up is very fast, but I think it only helps with the boot up when it boots up first. But anything else, loading programs and stuff, I think I had Premiere, Photoshop, Lightroom, all running at the same time, and it wasn't much of an issue, and that wheel wasn't showing as much as before, so which is pretty good. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna do show you some file transfers and see if it's faster or slower. You can compare it to yours. If you already have a hard drive installed in it, so you can compare it, and then I'll show you the rest of it and inside the computer. So let's jump in there. So right now we're just gonna go into about, and I'm gonna show you how much RAM I have. So I installed the 16 gigs RAM. So I did install 2 8-slots. 8 gig slots, and yeah, so and with storage, of course, this is the one we installed, Mac 1TB SSD. And then I'm gonna go inside the activity monitor, and then I'm gonna show you that yeah, you do have like 16 gigs and how much is used, how much is cache. But this is generally, this is, but I also use another app where actually it's easier, it shows you better. And as you can see, and then this is cool because it shows you everything, all the programs that's using, the memory, of course Final Cut Pro is using it at the moment, and then but you can press in the middle of it and it will actually get rid of the memories and make it easier for your computer. And this is just a speed test for the computer while it was transferring files. So it took about 8 minutes, it took about 6 minutes for an 8 gig files to transfer. Of course I had to speed this up, but and then of course I had to do a disk speed test. It used to be 25 with the hard drive, but now it's 453 and 505 read and write. And then also I'll just do some app load times. Of course with Chrome it did like opened in 2 seconds, Apple Maps opened in 3 seconds, Adobe Lightroom, of course these are heavier and more things going on, so 6 seconds. And then of course Photoshop as well. But Photoshop took the longest, I don't know why, but it did, because there's a lot that's going on in the background. And 18 seconds, there was probably faster because this loading thing, maybe it was just trying to load a big file that I had there, but if you don't have anything it should be faster. And then finally Final Cut Pro X, it took 16 minutes. I think it's a big application, and it took, you know, it took forever to load as well. But that's the loading time, you know. If you can upgrade, avoid upgrading your computer. If it's a brand new, like let's say a 2016, 2018 version to upgrade to RAM or something, yeah, it's worth it. But anything less than 2015, like, you know, past 2015 and below, it's not worth it. Because I'll give you an example. It's like showering and then putting the same old clothes back on. What, you're stinking, you're still gonna stink. So the same thing, computer has lots of parts, and just because we upgrade the RAM doesn't mean the battery is gonna hold up, doesn't mean the screen, there's a lot of other parts in there, and it might just heat up because of the speed. Yeah, in my experience with my computer, when I upgraded, the problem with it was it performs very well for a little bit, and then it goes back to the normal old computer that it is. So that's why I've smashed it a couple times as well. All right, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you made it to the end, thank you so much. I really appreciate it, this channel appreciates it. And if you're subscribed, thank you so much for coming in and supporting me. And if you're new, make sure you subscribe and smash the like button, and make sure you leave a comment down below and let me know your thoughts. And if you have any issues or anything, comment it below and I'll get back to you.